All praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahawashi, Bashem, Rakakadash.
All right, shalom, brothers and sisters in this truth. I'm your brother, Mr. LJ, coming to you again with another lesson. Lord willing, this will be edifying to those of you who are tuning in. And today we're going to go and look at the wisdom of Solomon chapter 2 here. And this is actually for this title, which you see on the screen here, Unable to Connect. And this is talking about the Jake that we have here in this wicked queendom. Okay, so I'm going to go into the precept right now, starting with verse 1. For the ungodly said, reasoning with themselves, but not aright. A life is short and tedious, and in the debt of a man there is no remedy. Neither was there any man known to have returned from the grave. For we are born at all adventure, and we shall suffer hereafter as though we had never been. For the breath in our nostril is a smoke, and a little spark in the moving of our heart, which being extinguished, our body shall be turned into ashes, and our spirit shall vanish as a soft air. And if any of you have ever been to a funeral, what do they always say? Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Okay, and the mentality that Jake you see have here right now, as you can see inside this picture here that I mishmashed together, here a couple of people here, you have Slim Tug, Tyler Ferry, an NBA player there, and then some other Jakes there, all agreeing with Esau wickedness in this pandemic and this vaccination that's going on right now. Why? This is an attempt to continue on in this wicked queendom and its ways, its wickedness and abomination, you know, and things that in continuing into being involved in things that is offensive to Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. Okay, they want to sustain their life here, and that's the reason why they think you only have one life to live. Okay, and afterwards you just, that's it. All right. Continuing. And our name shall be forgotten in time, and no man shall have our works in remembrance, and our life shall pass away as a trace of a cloud, and shall be dispersed as a mist that is driven away with the beams of the sun and overcome with the heat thereof. Now let's take a look at that first part where it says, and our name shall be forgotten in time, and no man shall have our works in remembrance. And what is the main thing that always comes out with just about everything? That's the reason why you have the Academy Award, why you have the Music Award, you know, why you have this award, that award, and everything is just always an award. Even at your job, they want to give you an award just for showing up. Why? It is to keep that vanity, that vain spirit inside of you, the wickedness, to continuously wanting to propel yourself in this society, okay? You know, you don't want to be a nobody, okay? And this is the reason why they're able to get so many people to line up to go take something that hasn't even been approved by their own organization called the FDA that, you know, would normally take 10 to 15 years. Do you know how many corporations or many businesses have gone under that had products that didn't get FDA approved? Okay. And some of them actually, you know, they actually had IPOs, you know, which is a stock, you know, trying to raise the money to get their stuff approved. I actually invested in one or two of these companies, you know, I lost my money. Why? Because the product that they were going to bring out that was supposed to help you, okay, it wasn't a liquid or anything like that. It was a product, did not get FDA approved. But all of a sudden, they can go with an emergency for this invisible, you know, pandemic. And all of a sudden, people just line up like goats to go get this shit. You know, really stupid. And this is because of that vanity. Continuing. For our time is a very shadow that passes away, and after our end, there is no returning. For it is fast sealed, so that no man cometh again. Come on, therefore, let us enjoy the things that are present, and let us speedily use the creatures like us in the youth. And that's why you're seeing the youngsters in America right now, the way they are. They call them Generation Z right now. You see, they're so wicked right now, you know. I mean, anything goes. You get the little fairies, you know, Nas X, and, you know, what was hip-hop, which you just sing about the oppression of our people, now suddenly turn into this faggotry, abominable, homosexual, you know, wickedness right now, okay? And this is not even being hidden anymore. And that's how we know we are in the end, and this place is going to be burnt up by nuclear holocaust, and this place is going to go suffer judgments after judgments after judgments, starting right now with this these lockdowns and these hey, take the jab or no job for these proud wicked ass motherfuckers out here right now, okay? Continuing. Let us fill ourselves with costly wine and ointments, and let no flower of the spring pass by us. Let us crown ourselves with rosebud before they be withered. Okay, so there's always this hastening. You know, you got to get everything done right now. You know, we can't wait. You know, let none of us go without the part of our voluptuousness. Let us leave tokens of our joyfulness in every place, for this is our portion and our lot is this. Okay, now you take a look at that. Okay, let's look at the word joyful, voluptuous. Voluptuous means sensuality, the quality of being sensual, sexuality, the quality of being sensual, the quality of being voluptuous. Okay, so now when you look at that particular sentence again, let's look at that chapter, let's look at that verse. Let none of us go without his part of our voluptuousness. Let us leave tokens of our joyfulness in every place. And this isn't this true? Everywhere Esau goes, guess what? All of a sudden, that nation started to emulate them. Okay? I stopped traveling. Why? Because everywhere looks just like America. Okay? You know, you got the islands, you know, whereas, you know, they have a thing, you know, they call homos over there, Batiman. Okay? I mean, you would actually get, you know, Bati boys got their ass kicked down there. They never stepped out. But now, if you go to the islands right now, they got Batiman villages and town and the rice, and it's duplicated. America, wickedness is duplicated in those islands right now. Okay? And so that's where they leave their joyfulness in every place. Hey, get to be like us. Okay? You know? And that's our people. They want to, they take part of this. This is why you see them involved in a lot of the wickedness of East, what Esau does. They contribute to it also too. All right? Because they don't have any understanding that there is a judgment that comes with this. All right? Let us oppress the poor righteous man. Let us not spare the widow, nor reverence the ancient gray hairs of the age. Let our strength be the law of justice, for that which is feeble is found to be nothing worth. Okay? So they don't look at the prophets and the elders out there, you know, trying to save their soul, trying to bring them back to this truth, to know their power. They believe they only have one life, which is far from the truth, because if you go into Numbers 14 and 18, it says, the Lord is long suffering and of great mercy, forgiving iniquity and transgression, and by no means clearing the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation. Guess what? We are our fathers. Okay? We are our fathers. So whatever we do, we get to pay back. We get to pay back in that. And they're going to get that payback. Okay? They're going to get that payback. And that's right now. Because this is the wicked Jakes back in the day who were complaining in the desert. Okay, when we got freed from Egypt. And they're back in Egypt today right now complaining, and now they're working with the Egyptians. These are the same ones who, you know, shouted crucify him, and had our king, Yahawashi, hung from a doggone tree. Okay? When they could have actually, you know, say, hey, let's hang the murderer, okay, and the thief. No, they hung our king instead, okay? So that's them here today, okay? They've chosen their sides, okay, and you can see it. Continuing, let our strength be the law of justice, for that which is feeble is found to be nothing worth. Therefore, let us lie in wait for the righteous, because he is not for our turn, and he is clean contrary to our doings. He upbraided us without offending the law, and objected to our infamy, the transgressions of our education. He professed to have the knowledge of Yahweh Bashim Al-Shai, and he called himself the child of the Lord. He was made to reprove our thought. He is grievous unto us, even to behold, for his life is not like other men's. His ways are of another fashion. And you're damn right. Okay? These Edomites are of another fashion. Okay? You can't see what is going on here, Jake. Wake up, man, Jake. But you're not to be waking up. Okay? This isn't for everybody. Okay? 1 John 1 and 9 says, if we confess our sin, he's faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now, let me show you what Jake them like to follow. See, they'll never listen to the prophets because, see, the prophets don't look like these guys. Okay? Look at this shit. Okay? You gotta come and put a show on for Jake to be entertained. Because, see, Jake likes to be entertained right here. So Jake likes to see suits, you know, offering plate, you know, some special effects, you know, those kind of things here. Okay? That's what Jake likes to see right here. Here it is right here. When this man walks around like that, this guy actually forgives sins. Okay? When we all know that only Yahweh Bashim Yashai can forgive sin, only our king can forgive sin, only the Most High can forgive sins, okay? If we repent and confess our sin. But see, they go to this guy sitting in the room here, spanking his monkey, and he tells you, you're forgiven, you know? And they live in, see? Because see, Jake likes to see luxury and stuff of that. So these are the type of people, you know, that Jake like right here, you know? Jake is very... very gullible and into looking at all these different things. So, you know, Jake will never be able to connect, so to speak. Jake will never be able to connect. He's not going to be able to connect with the wicked two-thirds. He's not going to be able to connect with Yahawashi. Never will be able to connect with Yahawashi, Yahawashi. You know, they're cut off and they're set here to be destroyed here in America because why? They want to go here and choose to go and follow the wickedness of this land. And they surely as hell are not going to be connected to us. They're not our brothers and sisters. Okay? They're not our brothers and sisters. And the day will come as they follow Esau, and it's going to come very rapidly and surely. Let me show you a little something here. See this here? Now, some of you have watched this guy here in Fox. He says, Tucker Carlson rails against employee vaccine mandates after firings. Okay? Now, he's going on, and you can see here that there's a civil war that's brewing here. Could these Edomites, okay? And the brother Amon Abad showed a video with an Edomite. I don't know how he got that damn weapon, but boy, he had a weapon that he modified to a machine gun. And he's saying, mandate this. They are prepared. These Edomites are stocking up food. They have a lot of their weapons, and they're prepared to go against his government. Jake is going to be caught up. Okay? And understand this, Jake. Okay? You side with Esau, you know, for your job and all the other shit like that. He's going to kill your ass because the Yahawashi Mashiach is going to make him do it. Two, you're also going to get killed. You're also going to get hunted down by these guys who are opposing their princes too. Okay? Remember, they're not going to regard their prince or their kings. Okay? And there's going to be a sedition among men. Just quoting there. Okay? So they're going to see you as an enemy too because they're going to see you look at your living well, okay? Because you took the jab, you follow everything, okay? But you're going to be in derision and they're going to hunt your ass down too. And then don't turn to the one third. Don't turn to us, okay? Because we're going to kick you the fuck in the face too because you're not one of us. You just don't get it, okay? You just don't get it. You're unable to connect. You have no spirit that connects, all right? So I just want to just bring out this lesson today to those of you who are tuning in. Lord willing, I have another one that should be very interesting for you to see. And this is based on some headlines that I uncovered. Okay. With that, I'd like to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushad, Bashem, Rakakadash. I'd like to give a double shout out to the elders and apostle of Great Millstone and the brothers out there putting the truth. And to you brothers and sisters that are tuning in, Shalom.